Hey, welcome to my channel. I'm back and I hope everyone's having a great day or night depending on where you are. So I want to start by talking about this wig. It's Luna, her name is Luna, and it's from the Outre, the daily wig. I wore it out a couple of times and I want to start by talking about all the pros. So first, I love the color of it. It's a really nice blonde color. They have various colors on their website or on their line that you can choose from. I happen to pick this particular color. It has the dark roots and I just put some concealer and powder on there to make it look more scalp-like. So I really love how it moves when you get it. It's not too like wiggy, like shiny looking. It's kind of like has a sort of natural type of feel and look to it. It looks really, you know, really like professional, like as if you just came out of the salon. However, because it is so dense, it has like has a really thick amount of hair in the wig, it may look a little bit wiggy, depending on you. Like if your natural hair is like really thick like this, then maybe you can pull it off, but I don't know, for me it does look a little bit wiggy, but I like it nevertheless. Yeah, so the cons of the wig in my opinion are that it sheds. It did shed when, see, like even now there's some shedding going on. It does shed a lot more than the other one. The other one doesn't shed at all. And when you're having a black shirt or any shirt and you have some hair, stray hair, it's kind of like a little bit embarrassing, especially because it's blonde and it's such a high contrast. So that was a major con for me. If it didn't shed so much, then I would probably give it like a thumbs up or 100%. But right now, because of that, I'd give it like maybe 50% because I don't want to be embarrassed like that. So other than that, I do like how it looks on me. I think it frames my face really well. It obviously won't tangle a lot. It hasn't been tangling a lot because the shorter the wigs are, the less they tangle because they're not rubbing up on anything. So I do think that it is a great protective style if you want to grow your hair out. I have 4C hair, so I'm definitely in the process of growing out my hair, and I definitely make a habit of moisturizing my edges, applying oil to my edges, and making sure that my hair is properly cared for underneath. I also make sure that my hair is braided, like it's cane rolled flat, so it doesn't look bulky while I am rocking the wig. I would recommend maybe 15 to 20 cornrows underneath, small ones, so that it looks like natural, like I said, and not bulky, because it's a no-no for me. I really don't like that at all. The flatter, the better. So now I'm gonna try on the other wig that I have, the Ryan, from the same collection, so that I can compare the two for you and you can decide which one you like the best. Okay, so this is Ryan. I did try this one on about 2 weeks ago and I'm actually giving an update on it now. I love this one. This one is my favorite. It also comes in various like other color choices. I just so happened to pick this color because I think it's cute and it's colorful and it looks really natural in my opinion in comparison to the other one that I just tried on. I think it's like not as dense. It doesn't have as much hair like within the wig itself, so it's more lightweight and I feel like it just looks more like believable that this could be your hair. Same thing on the top, I put concealer and foundation to make it look more scalp-like. And overall, I do think that these wigs, especially this one, is very budget-friendly. Here, I bought it at the local beauty supply store for $39.99 Canadian dollars because I'm in Toronto. And yeah, it is gonna last like probably over a month, or if not a month, because I can just tell by the way how it's enduring, it's going to last me for a while. And it's very practical. All I do is wash it, let it air dry, and I'm good to go. Put it on and I'm straight. So definitely a really good investment and a really great protective style if you're also maintaining and taking care of your hair underneath. So this one is definitely a winner for me. Let me know in the comments below what you think, if you like this one or if you like the other one. Like I said, this one does not shed as much at all. So another thing I wanted to get into is the fact that yes, I am growing out my hair, and tomorrow I am going to be going to Curl Ambassador. It's a hair salon that they have experience dealing with like curly hair, kinky hair, and things like that. My sister recommended it, so I'm gonna check it out. Stay tuned for that. Subscribe to my channel if you wanna know what's that all about. Because I have done like a wash and go on my own hair, and I just wanna compare to see if I will have better results at the salon. And I will be referring, you know, back to you, like what products they used and what they do. And I'll show a picture right now to show you the results of my own wash and go. And then, yes, when I come back from the salon, you'll be able to see like if there's a difference or if it looks better, if it's exactly the same. Hopefully, I hope that it'll look better or there'll be more definition or something overall. It is winter right now, so I don't plan on probably doing the wash and go regularly until early spring, but I just want to have like a heads up on what I'm dealing with, and hopefully you can get a heads up too. So yes, and one more, and yes, finally, as you know, or you may not know, I am a makeup artist. I love makeup. I particularly love applying makeup on other people, so I am in the middle of developing a product or developing something that will be extremely valuable to you if you are also a makeup artist or aspiring makeup artist, or you just love makeup overall like me. This is going to be very, very helpful to you in your career and in your personal life. So I would definitely recommend that you hit that notification bell so you'll be notified when I come out with that. I promise you, this is going to be really, really, really useful. Anyhow, I think that's about it for me for today. I really hope that you enjoyed watching this video and that you gained some valuable insight. Don't forget to believe in yourself. Always keep a positive mind frame. And yes, I will see you in the next one.